On June 17th of 2023, the number of earthquakes centered underneath a populated volcanic island south of the island of Kyushu began to increase to abnormal levels. The island in question goes by the name of Kuchinoerabujima, which also is the name of its volcano, which has erupted on 16 separate occasions since 1841. Eruptions from this volcano in the last 20,000 years have been universally explosive, with some abnormally large events that registered in on the volcanic explosivity index as a 4, causing as much as 4 meters thick of ash and pyroclastic flow deposits to fall on sections of the island. One such VEI-4 eruption in 1933 to early 1934 wiped out a village on the island, causing one-third of the island's population to be casualties. Luckily, the vast majority of eruptions Kuchinoerabujima produces are two orders of magnitude less explosive than its 1933 to 1934 eruption, sending thick plumes of ash to a height of 2 to 8 kilometers into the sky, alongside ejecting bombs of lava, and often generating small to moderate length pyroclastic flows. While earthquake levels at presumably shallow depths of less than a kilometer began increasing on June 17th, by June 26th, a total of 100 volcano tectonic earthquakes had occurred. Since the rate of earthquakes kept increasing, Kuchinoerabujima's alert level was raised from 1 to 2 at 4:40 a.m. local time on June 26th. Yet, only 38 hours later, its alert level was raised again from 2 to 3, translating to an increase from yellow to orange, which is now the same alert level as the currently erupting Sakurajima volcano. This second increase was triggered by 50 earthquakes occurring in the last 24 hours, with the possibility that this rate might further increase. Alongside this, a 100-meter-high white gas plume began rising above one of the three main craters on the island, known as Shindake Crater. This is an important development, as it suggests a change in the volcano's shallow hydrothermal system, which is located at a mere depth of 100 meters. If this is experiencing increased heat and thus producing more gas, it could indicate a sufficient pressure and temperature exists for water to flash to steam and explode, creating the potential for a phreatic volcanic eruption to occur. Beneath this hydrothermal system is a shallow storage area magma can pull at during and before an eruption at a depth of around 400 to 700 meters. Thus, if volcano tectonic earthquakes are highly clustered at those depths, it suggests that magma is on the move. But the exact depths of these quakes has not yet been published. As a result of this uncertainty, combined with the increased number of earthquakes, a 2-kilometer exclusion zone has been declared in all directions surrounding the volcano. Although there are not yet signs of an imminent eruption right now, phreatic eruptions are incredibly difficult, sometimes impossible to predict, so there is a chance that a new volcanic eruption could occur with little or no warning. The 2-kilometer exclusion zone represents the approximate maximum radius an unexpected volcanic eruption could throw bombs of molten rock or ballistic blocks given a small to medium-sized event. If a hypothetical small to medium-sized eruption were to occur, the western flank of the Shindake crater would be most at risk, as while pyroclastic flows can theoretically go in any direction, they tend to travel downhill and are funneled into low points in regional topography. Shindake's crater has a 30-meter or 98-foot high rim on its eastern side, but its western side has a breach crater rim which is lower than the center of the crater, where a hypothetical eruption would be most likely to begin. Longer-reaching pyroclastic flows will be most likely to travel along one or more of the two drainages, but could theoretically traverse higher spots to the west, or even go beyond the eastern crater rim heading towards the drainage to the east. Typical eruptions at Kuchinoerabujima are phreatomagmatic or volcanian, with both commonly ejecting bombs of lava and creating an orange glow of andesite lava at the active crater. While half of this volcano's eruptions last less than 24 hours, its eruptions have been documented as lasting up to approximately 4 months in length. While Kuchinoerabujima, during its 500,000-year lifespan, has created a multitude of volcanic craters, only one has produced every single eruption in the last 150 years, Shindake Crater. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.